Let's begin reading the annual report of Asian Paints 2019-2020 financial year. So let me dive deep directly into the annual report. I'm going to be covering it in a very, very minute manner, the entire annual report. We've taken a relatively company that one that you know, Asian Paints, a brand that is known, the product, the brand. And second, it's relatively easy to start a company's analysis or to start looking at an annual report of a manufacturing company or so, as compared to a banking, insurance, AMC, etc. company, which also we look at, right? But later, but let's first understand the annual report. So before we actually get to the contents page also, there's a first page, second page. Actually, second page is page 2 and page 3. That is how we are going to go ahead with. So this is going to be the cover page. I'm going to analyze every single page over here. And then we have page 2 and page 3. It's like an opening kind of page or something. Then we have the table of contents, which is divided into three parts, and I'll come to it. I'll explain every single thing, including the formats and everything also. So be very, very attentive, and it is going to be extremely interesting to start with the annual report of a company and analyze and understand how to read it, how to understand, how to read between the lines, whether you're looking at merging with a company, acquiring it, investing into it, loan or giving a loan to the company or whatsoever it may be. So just give me 1 minute and give me some time. Let me first start, then I'll tell you how, then you'll start understanding the details. So first of all, when you're looking at the first page, you also need to understand your PPT, Excel, Word, and all those things need to be absolutely great, because you need to be able to make the entire report yourself. I'm not asking you to do it. I'm not going to give you a task to do it, but you should be able to make a basic annual report, even if the designing presentation is required. Normally, corporates as large as Asian Paints and all will also have a design team which is going to be helping them to execute this. So I'm going to be in that level of detail. So when you're looking at that, obviously the logo of the company is going to be there, the company name is there, Asian Paints Limited. When you're looking at a US company, UK company or something, incorporate Asian Paints INC or something could also have been there. Then we are looking at the annual report. So it is not quarterly, it is not the half yearly report. So we have the quarterly reports also issued. It's the annual report for the entire financial year. And 2019-2020 is the financial year. What have I written over here? Eased company, Asian Paints, annual reports. Okay, I'll have to check that. Anyway, so 2019-2020 is the financial year. So there is a cover image they've chosen. Obviously, when they choose a coverage image as well, there is that tells a lot. Achha, some companies also have a calendar year. So 2019 to 2020 is obviously financial year. If it would have been a calendar year, Seat Tyres, I think, follows a calendar year. There are certain companies which follow calendar year. In that case, 2020. So that is 1st January 2020 to 31st December 2020. But when I'm looking at 1920, obviously I'm looking at a financial year. So now when you're looking at it, even as we move towards into the annual report, you will see that it's always about impacting lives, transforming lives. So that is going to be their core model over here. So the cover image also they choose is relatively logical. There is always something there. So the tagline, bringing joy to people's lives. So obviously, even when Nike is selling shoes, it's not about shoes, wear the shoes are comfortable. It's always about just do it or something. They always have something beyond the product. So that is how they sell. So you'll have to read a lot of marketing and all of that in order to understand those areas. Transforming spaces, homes, and lives. Space is again a 3D. It's three-dimensional. So when you're looking at a wall, it is two-dimensional. But when you're in a space, it's a three-dimensional. Right? So spaces is different as compared to walls. So when you're looking at Asian Paints, it's only about the wall paint. No, that is not how we are looking at it. It's going to be transforming the entire space around you. So actually, so design thinking and all these things are also very, very interesting, to read about, because it's not that I'm a designer or I'm a marketing person. It's actually I'm learning all the facets of management also. So it's important to grow how you talk to people, how you present, you negotiate. Everything is important. Of course, after I got a certain level of specialization in my finance domain, then I started upgrading myself in other domains by reading books and talking to people and all of that. The photo credit has also been provided over here. It is important that these kind of companies don't get into any kind of wrongdoing or any kind of activities as such. Now, when you're looking at this page, so this was the cover page, the one in the front page. The moment you open left and right, there are two sides to the page. These are the two sides. So every slide we are going to look at, it's going to be the page this way. So we are reading the left and the right side both, right? So when you're looking at this, let me just show you the entire layout first, and then I'll show you the each segment. So over here, if you notice, we've written, we've read Transforming Spaces, Homes and Lives. Let's come over here. So when you're looking at Asian Paints, so we'll have a very quick read about the company, then Transforming Spaces, Homes and Lives, 1, 2 and 3. So when you're reading, it's important. I like to scribble. I really write, like, I enjoy to write down that 1, 2 and 3, because it registers that, okay, this is what the company is, this is what the core area is, this is how the company, because even when they come up with their ethics, mission, vision, values, when they come up with their taglines and all, there is a lot of brain, there is a lot of strategy, long-term thought process, etc., that goes into that tagline. It's not a random effort or a random goal. So the two pages that I see when I open is going to be Asian Paints, Spaces, Homes and Lives. And I'm not going to read it. It is your job to read it. I'm going to be highlighting all the things, how you need to read, how you need to, what all you need to derive from those single lines and all. Innovative and unique solutions. You have to understand this. Asian Paints is one of the most innovative companies because they treat themselves as a technology company and not just a paint company. So you'll have to read. I told you that the task before this particular annual report of Asian Paints was that you read the Asian Paints story from Unusual Billionaire's book. You need to read that story, that 130 page story on Asian Paints, and you'll understand what I'm saying. So it's about innovation. It's revolutionary change. And these are the three segments they are catering: spaces, homes and lives. Sorry. When I'm looking at the spaces aspect, so when I'm looking at the spaces, it is about not selling product, but an experience. That is how these people try to market. I don't want to get into too much of marketing aspect. Not so known regions also of India, they are trying to get into the rural tier 2, tier 3 segments. Even when we do the con call part, you'll be able to corroborate with that the sales the management, and I'm going to say we, because I'm also part of Asian Paints now. I'm a shareholder of Asian Paints, so therefore I'm a very small, tiny bit owner of Asian Paints, and I'm analyzing it. It is my company. I have to analyze thinking it is my company. I am Asian Paints now. So that is how much of depth you need to get into the company. So not so known regions also, they're trying to get it. They want to cater to the citizens across the country. The focus is, and we need to see the segments and all. So segment wise sales, we'll have to see tier 2, tier 3, what kind of products. They will have products in ranges which are expensive and at a lower cost also. So which product is having more volume sales? That will also give me an idea about what is their core market, what is the kind of consumer segment that they are catering to. So rural tier 2, tier 3 cities also. Sorry, second was niche kya? One second. Then the second one was transforming homes. So when you're transforming homes, they're getting into dream homes. So again, you're selling a dream, you're selling a house. So it's not that you're going to be selling paint. Okay, my paint is better, uska texture is better, or I'm giving you a cheaper. It's not that. You're selling dream homes, ingenious products. The products, the quality, the innovation that they have is absolutely something that they bank on. Again, you have to read that Unusual Billionaires, I told you. Decor. That is a new segment, beautiful home segment they are adding to, which we'll get into which we'll get an idea later, right? And then we have the interior design service they're getting into. We have another page where we'll be looking at another area in the balance sheet, annual report, where we're going to be looking at the segment of products that they're getting into. They're getting into the entire design solution, that you come to a house, we'll take care of everything. And that is why it is not just a paint or a wall. There is not 4 tubs of paint kept over here. It is rather, we are looking at more of the entire transformation decor. They're getting into sanitary ware, kitchen business, etc. Also modular kitchens and all. They're going to be foraying into that. And the next part is, we are going to be transforming lives. How are you going to be transforming lives? There is a little bit of CSR activities given, mobile medical units and all they've been creating throughout the COVID. I'm not getting into too much of details, but it is a good brand promotion in a way. Your branding, your reputation that you're trying to project in the market, it impacts a lot. Stakeholders, we are looking at difference in our stakeholders. When you're transforming lives, it's not going to be just shareholders, profitability, but employees, safety taken care of, the people, the laborers who are doing all the paint and all the job at your homes and all. So all those are going to be taken into consideration as well. So because of that, they've come up with Health Shield, asthma and allergy friendly variant also of their paint. There are people who have these issues with dust allergy and all of that. So they're coming up with different variants and all. And this health and hygiene segment, where they're also going to be getting into antibacterial coats and all of that. That is a need of the hour, given the COVID situation and the post-COVID situation. Their objective is always going to be customer centric, and they are getting into a lot of skilling programs. This is actually very important. I'll tell you why. Because today the problem is with respect to the unskilled labor. Unskilled labor is one of the most important challenges that we are facing in our country at the moment. When you're looking at that, the skilling programs is very, very important. Now, I've actually seen other companies also do this. So they have a mandatory CSR spend. Now, what they do is they will do the CSR spend in order to train, provide training. Let's say a BPO company, they are going to be doing training employees in fluent English or something, right? Or in basic technical skills or etc. Now, why would they do that? Because out of the people that they are training, they are going to be recruiting those people into their company itself. So CSR also, the companies try to create some kind of synergy in the CSR activity also. Skilling is very important. Why I'm telling you is because people today get very annoyed with they are very used to that good service. That even if I'm booking an Uber, I don't want the person to ask me the location. I want him to come to my doorstep and I sit in the car, cashless, absolutely. I get off at the place. I don't have to explain him the way also, the route also, and I don't have to pay him, change anything, nothing at all. And I just get off without any communication, without any kind of problem, without any kind of hassle. Or say for example, a Swiggy. I don't want the person to call me and ask me where the location is. So we want that service. Today the service component has become a challenge, and because of the unskilled labor, it has become a major challenge. So skilling labor is something that, and Asian Paints actually has a reputation. I have a personal experience also with Asian Paints that the quality of output is good. The timelines, they maintain the timelines because managing labor and all is a major challenge, and they can charge premium for the same. So the skilling programs is something where they are portraying it as if it is a CSR activity, but also it contributes towards, it also helps them generate more sales. So this was page 2 and 3. Then we move to the next page where we are going to be looking at the contents over here. So in the contents, actually what we see over here is, and don't worry if you're not able to view exactly, I'll give this file to you. You'll have this file. You can open the file on your phone or whatever along with the class and lecture, and you can see that. So they've got this art piece over here. So they have a community kind of a community street initiative that they've taken, where they're having some portrayal in, you know, public places. Let's say a public toilet is there, and there they have painted the entire thing. That's also gives them a little brand presence or something. And they obviously will write by Asian Paints, maintained by Asian Paints. You to see our local politicians, even if they install a dustbin, there will be a big hoarding that this dustbin is installed by so and so person. In Calcutta, we have all the bus stands are small, dilapidated. Even if it is dilapidated, it's actually quite good right now. But the bus stands also that are there, it's a huge 2-3 line. This thing is given up. What do you call it? Anyways, I don't want to get into that. So anyways, this art piece is there. We've got some figures over there. We are going to come to that. That's like a very broad summary of 2019-2020 figures. But this is a table of contents. Now I want to zoom into the table of contents a bit. So when I'm looking at the table of contents, so you must know the general idea, generally, that, you know, what are the aspects that are covered, and there could be peculiarities for different industries and all, but in broad area, broadly, what are going to be the areas covered into the annual report is something you need to know. So the first part is going to be strategic review, where most important is your management discussion and analysis, where of course we understand what the management's MDA is going to provide an outlook on where the company is headed, what they've achieved, what are their major acquisitions, divestments, management changes, plans, energy consumption, foreign currency, etc. All those things are going to be discussed over here. So it's more about a discussion, more about an analysis, what the company thinks it's going to be, where they're going to be moving ahead. A 10-year review of the standalone consolidated statements also. Chairman's message, board of directors message, and MD and CEO's desk and all. They'll be talking about the brands, the products. Key rate indicators is going to be a little important. COVID response is something which is very important for this year. And it is also going to tell you as to how the company is going to tackle and what are the challenges they are facing. It's question on going concern, whether the company is going to exist or not. In Asian Paints, we don't need to think about it. CSR is, you know, we try to look at CSR from a synergy point of view and branding point of view, because CSR, generally the companies try to capitalize. Whether it's good or bad, it's absolutely up to you to think about it. But they want to use CSR activities also as a branding opportunity. And also a synergy, as I told you, train the people and then I will only hire them. So train the people that way. So that is your strategic review. The second part is going to be statutory reports, which is you have to do these filings. Auditor's report is there, and corporate governance report and all of that. shareholder information, holding and all that. We'll go through each of them. And financial statement is the third part, where you have standalone financial and consolidated, standalone Asian Paints alone, and then consolidated, including all the subsidiaries. You'll have the profit and loss account, the balance sheet, the cash flow statement, auditor's report and all also we'll see, and most importantly, the notes to accounts. And here we'll have the financials. So we'll be looking at that part at the end. So these are the three segments. So what are the three segments we've divided it into? Strategic review, statutory report, and financial statements. I'll just come back to this one in a while. Now, if you see the next page, see the header and footer of the next page. In the next page, when you see the header and footer, the header has strategic review, statutory reports, and financial statement. In PPT class, in PowerPoint, when I do the lecture for corporate presentations and all, in that we have, this is called the home slide approach. So what we've done is strategic review is bold black over here. The other are gray in color, statutory report and financial statement. Till the table of contents, till all the in all the pages, when you're running through the strategic review, MD&A, CEO message, board of director message and all, this will be black, those two will be gray. The moment we move to those sections where we are talking about corporate governance and all, then statutory report will become blank, these two will be gray. And when you are covering the pages of annual report, balance sheet, PL and all, these two will become gray and that will become black. So it tells you exactly in which part of the annual report, in which segment of the annual report are you currently residing. Now we look at some very basic summary data that has been provided over here. So obviously it's going to be very, very important to analyze over here. So financials summary is given. It's with a star mark, they've already mentioned it is a standalone figure, so clarity is needed. Revenue is up by 4.9%, your EBITDA is up by 11.2%, and your EPS, earning per share, is up by 24%. So we need to again look at the leverage aspect. We do these discussions in the con call also. Profit after tax has gone up by so and so percent. PAT and EPS generally is going to be more or less at the same percentage level. The increase or decrease percentage part. Environment they focused on over here, they're talking about the fresh water consumption, renewable energy capacity, flexible plastics collected and all of that. That is more of a CSR or more of a stakeholder approach where you know you have to take care of the environment, the society from which you're drawing out all the resources. Also, I would want to see this. See, water is going to be a major challenge in the future, which across the world we all understand. And the government also has taken cognizance of the same and started with the Jal Jeevan scheme and all. And now when you're looking at, and we have water futures, now they've started trading in the US exchange. So we understand that the water is going to be a major problem over here. So today, even when the new buildings and new apartments are being constructed, you would see that they are always catering to rainwater harvesting and minimizing using certain flow water for gardening activities. And those small things have become very important. So how are they evolving technologically today is also very important to understand over here. But obviously, you know, given from a very financial point of view that I'm going to look at it, I'll probably not give so much of focus over here. Obviously, my 90% focus or 80% focus is going to be in the financials. And when I'm saying focus on the financials, to make projections, you have to understand the business and the industry very well. That is why I'm getting into so much of depth of the understanding. The business industry understanding is extremely important, because otherwise, how do I assess growth? How do I think that why Asian Paints is going to do better than Berger? So I need to compare both the companies. I need to have a basic understanding of the paint industry, of how the consumers are thinking, how the branding is being done, how the positioning of the product is being done. I need to understand all of those factors. When you're looking at the social aspect over here, the CSR spend, how much is that? And employees and all, how much? 7,600 plus employee hours contributed to employee engagement activities. Not very important, to be very honest. I'm not getting into this part right now. We'll see when we come to the CSR portion of the annual report. There is a CSR report also in the statutory report section over there. I'll look at it. Now we'll start with the first segment over here, that is a strategic review. In the strategic review, we are, first of all, we are going to be looking at the company profile. We have the company profile. Second part we are going to be looking at, we'll have a CEO message, I believe. Chairman's letter. Then we'll have the management's letter. So this is how we move forward. I'm going to be speeding up now. I'm just going to very quickly go through it. It is going to be your responsibility to read the entire annual report word to word. Because one annual report, one company, you prepare it so thoroughly that you know exactly in and out how a company is done. Then it's only about a different company to be taken. And we'll probably give you another company to do your homework on. I'll come to that part later. But let's understand this company first. So when I'm looking at company profile, home decor for decades. These people have been in the business for a very, very good long-term period, 75 years or so, if I'm not wrong. And therefore, that has built a credibility and goodwill. And that is why these people are the market leaders. 75 years, sorry. And consumer focus innovation. Innovation, again, as I told you, when you read the annual report, the story of Asian Paints in the book I recommended, Unusual Billionaires, you'll understand the innovation part, because you have to also understand the story, the timeline, the way the company has evolved over time. That is why the innovation part is very important, which I'm telling you repeatedly. Then when you're looking at the industrial use, the company is also into the paint segment for industrial use, not only just the decorative part of it. And that is why there are going to be correlations. So that is why we need to look at the correlation aspect also. You can read. So correlation aspect with the other industries and all. Decor consultancy, as I told you, they are moving towards from a product driven company to a service oriented company, where they're going to be consulting and doing your entire house, everything. Ethics is something they have always focused on, and that is why propelling a growth and therefore the branding, the goodwill of the company being created. They have a couple of joint ventures with companies and all in order to get into automotive coatings, etc., different markets. I'll have to come back to it later. There is another page I'm going to be discussing on the brand portfolio and the product portfolio. Over there I'll get into more details. Just a second. Kuch tha upar? No, it was just an image. On the right side of the page, we're looking at home improvement. Home improvement, I told you, they're getting into two segments, beautiful homes. They have kitchen, that is sleek, is a major player. The branding has to be done so that people are not confused. You have to create different brands for different segments in order to create a brand recall and in order to educate the customer. If you put all the brands, everything is Asian Paints, then how do I distinguish between a good quality or an expensive one, a cheaper one, the kitchenware, the sanitaryware, etc.? So kitchen, and SS is a prominent player, they're getting into the sanitaryware. All stakeholders to conserve water, energy and all, this is what they're looking at. So this is a very broad overview that we are looking at in terms of the brand aspect. Products and services, these are the list of products and services. So check sales and evaluate the importance and growth of the different product areas. So paint is there, chemical, automotive paint, bathroom fittings, kitchen, adhesives, fevicol kind of stuff. Services, home painting services, the entire labor. The labor is also provided by Asian Paints, which is actually very important in today's segment, that you give the contract to these people and then they're going to take care of the paint, the raw material, as well as the painting, the labor, the job. Interior design is something they're getting into with the beautiful homes and sanitization services, projects, etc. So getting into more of services. This part is going to be in detail a little later. So this is what the core business area or business segment is into. This is a very, very broad company profile. A very broad company profile. Then the next part is your chairman's letter. The chairman, Mr. Ashwin Dani. Okay, that's kind of my name. I didn't notice earlier. Again, bringing joy to people's lives. So always, you know, you have to start understanding how it is written. How do you portray? How do you pitch to the consumer, your product, your business, your idea? All right, so now he is writing a note to the shareholders. Now directly we are addressing to the shareholders. Of course, our responsibility is going to be this towards the stakeholders, but the annual report ultimately is for the shareholders. The growth and financial cannot be extrapolated without adjustment. We need to understand that. Wide cross-section of consumers are there. Therefore, you, and sorry, that was for this. One second, sorry. Chairman's letter, the shareholder joys. No, I'm forgetting the growth and financial. The growth and financials, the projections, what you have to do is you have to analyze in much depth, in with a lot of depth, in order to be able to make projections. So when we're looking at wide cross-section of consumers, we can witness different growth rates in different segments. Maybe the urban growth rate or the growth rate in the segment of paint may be, let's say, a very tiny amount because they're already there as a majority player for a very good time. But the growth rate when I'm looking at the kitchen or the sanitary ware could be very high. But when we look at the revenue from operations, when we look at the revenue projections, and not projection, the revenue breakup segment wise, you'll find that beautiful homes is probably contributing a very, very small amount as compared to the paint industry. It is in a very, very nascent stage. So the growth rate could be absolutely very widely different when I'm comparing the growth rate of a sanitary ware or a kitchenware business, a beautiful homes area segment, or when I'm comparing it to the regular paint industry. Healthy growth they have witnessed, but the lockdown happened, and that is FY 2020 end. So actual impact we are going to start looking at in the quarter one, quarter two of FY 2020-21. that is where we'll actually see, because lockdown happened just at the end of March. So April, May, June and July, August, September is where the spillover, the effect of COVID is going to start happening. So the lockdown was in the March in the last quarter. So if you need to make some adjustments, we will, of course, there'll be a lot of adjustments that will be required over here in this particular one. And then the second part he's talking about is transition. Transition, we're talking about the major changes that have happened in the company's management. So after 4 decades, the management, I think the MD has changed, the MD and CEO has changed. Again, being a product-centric to a consumer and service-driven organization, that is what we're looking at. Innovation, providing value to the consumer and turning into a service-oriented organization. It was a difficult environment, but still there was a healthy growth in the first 3 quarters. In the 4th quarter, we're not taking any responsibility, which had only 1 month of COVID. The environment anyways, even pre-COVID actually, the economy was in a relatively slow kind of a phase, if you notice. Also, what we have is another person who succeeded this with innovation, leadership, etc. There has been another change. Amit Singhal is CEO MD. So he's a new one. Sorry. Once again. Sorry. Undo. How do I undo? I deleted something over here. Anyways, I'll check that. So when we're looking at that, that is the MD and CEO change. The company secretary also has changed. And a lot of people, if you see, they're there for a very, very long duration in this organization. When you're looking at the changes over here, so just a second. So when you're looking at the change for projections and strategy, that is what I missed out. So when you're looking at the change, there is a major the people have been very, very old. The people have spent decades of their experience in the company. That gives a lot of indication about attrition rate being low. People are rewarded in sync with their contribution, and loyalty is rewarded when you see the kind of people who have been promoted. So that was a transition phase. 2-3 management changes, major management changes at a director level and at a, sorry, not director level, at the MD level. Key areas of focus for projections and strategy. What is their focus? Where do they want to expand? Where the company is headed? They're giving me an idea about it. They want to get into the decorative business over here. Where is that? One second. So where are they getting into? So value for money emulsions. So the paint and all, value for money relatively maybe on the lower cost side. Waterproofing and all, waterproofing on wood related waterproofing and all also they've started. So those paint coats and all, so as to make wood a waterproof material and all that, and furnishings and all. Full kitchen sanitary, where we've already discussed multiple times. International front also, they're trying to expand in these locations, Egypt, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka. Industrial business segment also, protective coating, they're getting into it. OEMs and all, we'll get into it. It'll come later somewhere else. OEMs is original equipment manufacturer. So basically the industrial goods and all people manufacture, uska bhi paint, painting that, providing protective coats and paints for that also, they're getting into. With respect to people and community, what does the chairman has to say? So he's talking about, check the exaggeration. This is not very important because this will be more about the CSR kind of activities they're going to talk about. At times people kind of, obviously they exaggerate and all. I'm not commenting on Asian Paints per se. I'm just telling you in general that happens and may not be a very, very important part for me to look at. So in Himachal, they're upskilling plumbers, etc. Plumbers upskilling again, you see the synergy because they're also getting into the sanitary ware segment. So they can train the plumber as a part of their CSR activity and hire those people later. Responding to the pandemic, obviously I need to understand what these guys are doing. They've given contribution to the relief funds and all. They've supplied essentials to the needy, etc. Hardships faced by retailers and contractors. This is also very important because ultimately, if, see, there is a paint shop. The paint shop could be selling you Asian Paints. He could be giving you Berger Paints product also. He could be selling you absolutely anything. Now, which is the product you will buy? You will immediately ask the shopkeeper that which one do you recommend. He might recommend Asian, he might recommend Berger Paints. Understand this. Now, if Asian Paints is going to take care of their retailers, contractors, etc. very well, don't you think they will have a more inclination to recommending Asian Paints? Of course, Page Industry also, the company that owns Jockey, these guys are also very much, they have very good presence in terms of they have very good connection and they give good margins and all to the retailers because ultimately the retailers are the ones who are going to push the product towards the consumer. So understand marketing strategy, product strategy, business strategy. It's very important to understand these things. And then how do you figure out these things? So your question could be that how do I know about it? There is something called channel check. So when you are analyzing a company and all, it is possible that you need to start doing calls. So I was talking to one of my students and he was a little irritated actually because he had to make 50 random calls. And with 50 calls, 40 people will hang up on your face or so. But you need to do your survey. So you go to, let's say, for page industry, I'll go to 20 innerwear shops and I'll talk to them that which brand sells the most. They might throw me out. At times you do calls, people may not take you very seriously. You go to their shops, you behave as a consumer and buy a couple of products. There's another kid who was telling me he bought a lot of electronic appliances from Wipro because he was liking their product portfolio. So Mayank was telling me that he's doing a research on that and he also wanted to try the products and all. So it's very interesting. So channel checks, you go, you talk to the people, you talk to consumers. This is all a part of finance, all a part of analysis. And it's very interesting because it's as if you own Asian Paints now. We do own Asian Paints if you're having even a single share. Then they also got into hand sanitizer, surface disinfectants. If I could use a phrase, aapda ko avsar mein badlo. So you change a problem into an opportunity over here. Then we have, and you've expanded your product portfolio here. Do we have something above this? No. Next part we are talking about is brand resilience. So it may not be too much important in terms of the profit and loss account, but it is very important in terms of reputational risk because people start immediately talking about it and writing on social media and all. So that impacts the companies today very, very clearly. So that is why we can just go through it at least. Innovation and all we already talked about a lot, and that's the chairman's message, Ashwin Dani. So next part is, I think, MD and CEOs. So MD and CEO's desk is the next one, which I think we are going to continue in the next class, next lecture. So you need to start reading the annual report with me and read yourself once so that when we are discussing, it is easier for you to understand and keep underlining and noting down points. So you'll also understand what did you skip or where you would have also thought about it. So it is going to take time. For those who are just starting with reading annual reports and all, it is going to be an ongoing process where you learn the entire phase of reading annual report, understanding, getting into this depth. Obviously, we're getting into this depth for one company and you'll be having 8, 10, 12 companies or whatever under your portfolio, in your portfolio. And that is also going to evolve. So within one industry, you're analyzing multiple companies, you'll start understanding better because it'll be very easy for you to make a peer comparison. But this is how we are going to read this one annual report at least to understand everything in and out, right?